And as we go to air, large parts of the East Coast are grappling with flood emergencies. This hour, a search has just resumed for a woman missing in floodwaters in Golgong, which is near Mudgee in the central New South Wales central west. Further north, people in Lismore just can't cop a break. Residents there bracing for their third flood event this year.
Similar nerves in Echuca in northern Victoria this morning, with the Murray River still rising. And a fresh threat is also brewing. A new weather system is currently tracking from South Australia, bringing even more rain.
Well, our reporters are standing by, ready to bring you all the latest alerts and warnings. Let's go first to Gavin Morris, who's in Lismore. Gavin, intense rainfall there overnight. What's expected over the coming hours?
Well, Ali, just starting to see some rain move back in at the moment. Very heavy rain overnight from that low. That is now just sitting off the northern New South Wales coast. So we're still getting buffeted by some very powerful winds. And all of that heavy rain from last night is now flowing downstream, and it's rising very, very quickly. We've seen a lot of debris now begin to float down the river as well. Behind me here, it's the old rowing club. This was actually once the headquarters for the SES. It's now completely abandoned. But we spoke to the SES a little earlier on, and this is what they had to say.
Ultimately, for this event, we don't believe that the events are going to be anywhere, or the outcomes will be anywhere near as significant as the previous event. There are still some concerns.
So where I'm standing at the moment, in the coming hours, I will be well and truly underwater. So all of that is going to flow downstream, and we're expecting the river to keep rising to around that 9 metre mark as we progress into this evening. But Ali, the levee wall up there sits at about 10.6. So the good news is that the CBD hopefully will not be inundated again. That's the good news. But obviously all of this is going to flow downstream as we move through the next couple of days, and that will cause flooding in those low-lying areas towards the coast. Ali?
Okay, thanks, Gavin.
Let's bring in Adam Hegarty in the Victorian border of Echuca. Adam, when is the river there expected to peak?
Well, David, it should be at some point today, but the rain we're having and experiencing at the moment certainly won't help matters. It will probably extend to that little bit further. But the damage here, as you can see behind me, this flooded street on the wrong side of the levee, that damage certainly done. I'm looking at houses now where the water's risen into the yards and front yards, now into garages, but further around the corner, more low-lying areas. People are already wading through knee-deep water, assessing the damage to their homes. The point is, residents here, even though there are those evacuate now warnings, people don't want to leave their homes. They want to protect them as long as possible. And that brings us to this. This is vision just in from across the border in Moama yesterday. This is about 3:30 yesterday afternoon. An elderly couple having to be rescued from a regional property there. They were there with their pet dog. They'd made their own levee around their property, wanting to stay. They had to be enticed out of their rescue crews. They say it took them about 3.5 hours to do that. That is the situation on the New South Wales and Victoria border. People want to protect their homes as desperately as they can in the wake of this.
Reading the information last night, it looks like they're hoping it'll max out at 95.2, but look, the local community, the fire rescue, SES, all the support agencies, we're just preparing for the worst and hoping for the best.
So still, unfortunately, a slow, agonising wait.
Thanks, Adam. Flood-weary Lismore residents are once again bracing for the worst as torrential rain falls on what is already saturated ground.
It's just unthinkable, isn't it? For the latest, we're joined by New South Wales Emergency Service and Resilience Minister Steph Cook. Minister, great to have you here on the show, but what is the latest on the situation in the Northern Rivers?
Well, we're continuing to see rainfall over that Northern Rivers region. And to give you an idea, the locality of Alstonville has seen around 200 millimetres fall in the last 24 hours. So we are continuing to see falls up there. The Wilsons River is continuing to rise through that Lismore area. We are anticipating that it will reach major level at some stage, either today and or into tomorrow. That, of course, is around about 9.7 metres. And the levee protecting the town and the CBD is 10.6. So we are hopeful that it will remain below that 10.6 metre levee. And, of course, we're all... we're all watching it very, very closely, as you can imagine.
Minister, a little earlier on the show, I was talking to a local business owner up in Lismore. Her name was Nancy Cassons, and the mayor up there. Just talking about the contradictions in the alerts they're getting, depending on whether that's from the Bureau of Meteorology, whether that's from the SES. I'll just play you what she had to say first.
On their Facebook page, on the Lismore SES Facebook page last night, it had minor flooding this morning, and then in the second sentence it had major flooding this morning. So two lines, one after the other, were saying conflicting. So it's conflicting within the SES here locally. And look, I'm not here to complain. They're volunteers and we need our volunteers. It's the information getting to us, Ali, that is incredibly frustrating.
So there you've got two different messages coming from within the SES, which was different again to what the bomb was saying. Where is this miscommunication happening? Where is it coming from? Because the impact it's having on those on the ground who've already gone through a lot is pretty devastating.
I understand people's anxiety, of course, particularly in that region at the moment. It's a highly dynamic weather system, as usual, in the Northern Rivers region. We continue to work with the best predictions that we are provided by the Bureau of Meteorology. They are working very closely with the SES. They are embedded, in fact, in our emergency management teams that are based right across New South Wales, including the Northern Rivers region.
So how come they've got different messaging now if they're working so closely together? And not in any way attacking here. I understand in a situation like this, there's a lot of things that are tricky to navigate. But I think, you know, when you're on the ground and you're nervous after what you went through in February, I think it's fair that the message is coming through is consistent from all emergency authorities.
Well, we do, from an SES perspective, look to refine our messaging as quickly as possible and give people the most up-to-date information that we possibly can based on the information that we are receiving from the Bureau of Meteorology. I appreciate that at times it may appear conflicting, but at the end of the day, we are genuinely doing our best to get that messaging out as quickly as possible. And at the end of the day, what we're really asking the community to do, which they are working very well with us at the present, is to be on alert and ready to evacuate at any moment should you be asked to do so.
Well, they're more than on alert, Minister. I mean, Mary was saying this morning that it's not just anxiety they're dealing with. Whenever rain happens, they're scared of the rain. They're scared of the sound of it. It's so triggering. This is the third time they're going through this. You know, decisions are being made about Lismore in Wollongong. Now, that's 663 k's away. This was an issue in February. Why hasn't this been rectified? Why aren't decisions being made on the ground there where it's happening?
Oh, well, with all due respect, David, they are. There is a 24/7 incident management team established and working out of Ganellabar. They are working with local police. There is an emergency operations centre set up. It is also working 24/7. That has liaison officers from every single government department and the local council. They are all embedded together. They are all working together and making sure that we get the best available information out to the community in the most timely way possible. I do accept that there is a lot of anxiety on the ground in Lismore. I was there on Friday ahead of all of this happening over the weekend. Mm-hmm. And yes, you are right. People are worried even when it does rain. So we are doing our best to work with the community. I appreciate that this is really, really difficult and challenging for them.
But Minister, if you're in Lismore and you pick up the phone and ring the SES, it is someone in Wollongong who's answering those phone calls.
Yes, but there is constant communication between whether it's here in the State Emergency Operations Centre, the headquarters of the SES in Wollongong, and the local team on the ground up there in Ganellabar. Those communication channels are entirely open. There is a constant flow of information so that we've all got the best visibility on the situation as possible, and that's with a view to keeping the community safe. That's what we're all about, and trying to give people the best information that we can as it comes to hand.
All right, Minister, we do appreciate your time. We know it's going to be a trying few days for everybody there, but certainly for the town as well. Thank you for your time. Echuca residents are in the grips of one of the town's worst weather events as the Murray River reaches its highest level in a lifetime. Martin Golich's home is on the wrong side of the levee, and he joins us now. Murray, thank you so much for your time this morning. We're so sorry this is happening to you, but those floodwaters peaked overnight. What's the damage there for you?
At this stage, it's only in my garage. It hasn't, gardens and all that replaceable stuff, obviously, but yeah, at this stage, it's only in my garage. Other houses down the street, they're actually over the floors.
You would have spoken to some of your neighbours down there where it's gone over the floors. How are they coping this morning? How are they feeling?
If they're feeling half as bad as I am, it's, look, I don't know how to describe it. We're devastated by what's happened. This was preventable. I watched the news last night about Lismore, and I don't know how they can do it three times in a row.
I mean, it's amazing that you can understand and also empathise with them, considering what you're going through, Martin. But, you know, how would you rate the response from authorities on the ground there?
They built this wall in 2 days. The guys were amazing. I understand they had to build it. It's a shame it wasn't built earlier. Since the wall was built, we've had nothing. There's been no one come down to even check. The only response I got the guys from the construction company to build this ramp over the road here so we could actually have some access. We decided to stay with their homes, and they are our homes. You know, where do we go? So we got this road built so we had access, and now they've put a pipe across it. We can't even get in anymore. We have been totally cut off and left.
Oh, Martin, this is just heartbreaking stuff. So are you saying, just to be clear, you're saying that since they built that levee, that's it? There's been no help for you guys at all. You've had to ask for a ramp just so you can access things. Then the pipes come in and it's just no help. No one's coming to see you. No one is checking on you.
Well, apparently the ADF are in town. Haven't seen them. The SES, well, they just do a fly through and have a look. There's no one. And our councillors, well, they're restaurateurs and coffee shop owners, you know. They're just normal people. They're not business people. They don't know how to run it. And obviously not.
Martin, you know, I'm hearing what you're saying this morning. What you're going through is just unbelievable. You know, people at home are looking at you and looking at you now and probably projecting their own emotions, but how are you feeling?
Anticipation at the moment. This water's really flowing now. The numbers they give you at the wharf, we're about 300 mil higher. It's just, I know it's coming. I just don't know how high. No one can tell us. It's a guess, I suppose. Me personally, I've been everywhere. I've been from upset, angry, depressed, just tired. I don't know how to explain it. It's just shocking.
You don't have to explain it. We can see it. And you know what? In the middle of all this, to speak to us is, we're so grateful for that. But please take care of yourself, Martin. We're going to check in with you again and make sure that everyone there is okay. You stay safe.
Hey, thank you. I just hope that when this is all over, they actually do something with this levee bank and put it where it's supposed to be, because this is avoidable.
You're exactly right, Martin. Thank you so much.
Yeah, well, they should have built that thing back in the 90s when they had the money for it. I honestly just don't know how much more people can cope with. And we're seeing what's happening there in Victoria. Then you just go back to the situation in northern New South Wales again, where Lismore's once again in the firing line. And joining me now is Lismore Mayor Steve Krieg and resident business owner Nancy Casson. Guys, I hate that I'm talking to you again, that we're back here. I know it's not as bad as we saw back in Feb, but if I can just go to you first, Steve, what is the latest information that you've got?
A bit conflicting, Ali. The SES has come out early this morning and said we'll get to a moderate flood at around lunchtime. The Bureau's still on their website and information still predicting possible major flooding into tonight. So I'm sticking with the SES.
And explain that to me, why you're sticking with the SES on this one and how it is that you've got these two different authorities who are putting out an entirely different message at the moment.
The SES are locals. They've got a network of about 30 residents all around our catchment that phone in and tell them how much water's fallen upstream. So I trust their information at the moment far more than the information coming out of Sydney.
Okay, and can I ask then, how are people feeling about this? We know people are still picking up the pieces from what we saw in February. To now be back here again, the emotional and mental trauma that must be causing some.
Yeah, you know, for me, I didn't sleep much last night. We only moved back into our home in the CBD about 4 weeks ago. And when you hear that rain on your roof constantly and quite loudly, you don't get much sleep. Obviously, the anxiety levels around town are very high. There's been businesses in the CBD and over in South Lismore that spent all day yesterday packing up, and you can't blame them for that. The warnings coming out were for predicted major flooding. Everyone's edgy. It's a very emotional town at the moment, Ali, to be honest with you.
Nancy, business owner, resident there of Lismore for a long time, how are you doing?
Not so good, Ali. I guess for me, I'm just hearing Steve talking about meters being fed into Lismore and meter readings and so forth. And that was my issue back in February that I complained about. It wasn't local. I actually rang SES for help yesterday with my business when I was packing up. And I was informed that SES's role is merely to door knock and get people out. They are there to save lives and that is it. And I wasn't able to speak to anybody locally here in Lismore. It was Wollongong that I got. So although when I rang, I said Lismore, waited, got put through, but when the lady was saying, nah, can't come and help you, I asked where she was. Wollongong. And their role is simply to save lives.
I mean,
another thing I want to point
Nancy?
Out is I looked on their face.
Continue, sorry.
On their Facebook page, on the Lismore SES Facebook page last night, it had minor flooding this morning, and then in the second sentence it had major flooding this morning. So two lines, one after the other, were saying conflicting. So it's conflicting within the SES here locally. And look, I'm not here to complain. They're volunteers and we need our volunteers. It's the information getting to us, Ali, that is incredibly frustrating.
And you know what? This is exactly what we talked about last time, right? That here you have decisions about a local community that are being made hundreds, thousands of kilometres away that are detached. We've had inquiries in regards to this. We knew this rain was coming. You would think this time there would be something in place to be able to tell people who are already frightened after what they've gone through, this is what's coming and this is the help we're offering.
I agree totally, and that was why, 6 months ago, this was my complaint. Decisions locally. And Steve, I know you said that you thought they were being made. Why didn't I get someone locally yesterday, Ali, when I rang? Mm. Why was there somebody in Wollongong saying there's nobody here to help me pack up? And I spent 3 hours in my shop yesterday packing up because I didn't want to lose everything like what happened in February. And as Steve said, it rains and I'm terrified of the rain, Ali. Terrified.
Oh. Nancy, and I think that is a sentiment felt by everyone in your town. You've got an amazing mayor there, Stevie, fronts up, he cares about his community. But for you guys to be going through this again is pretty rough, and I'm so sorry.